What's going on? I am Gregg Sussman, joined today by Tom Vecchio of FanDuel, who's here to break down some NHL futures for us. What's up, Tom?
Yeah, with the leagues on pause, we've got to be looking forward to get some value, some long-term championship bets here.
Absolutely. So let's begin in the Eastern Conference, where the Boston Bruins reside. They are your favorite bet on the board. Why is that?
Well, the Bruins really have it all. I mean, we look back to last season. They were, of course, in the Stanley Cup Final. They lost. But overall, this team really hasn't changed too much. And frankly, we have to be looking at this, time off of who's this going to benefit the most. And I think it's going to be benefiting the Bruins, and then another team we'll get to in a minute. But the Bruins are on the older side of teams. Chara is 42. Bergeron is 34. Marchand is 31. Rask is 33. Like, they have older players. So this time off will benefit them. And really, when it comes down to it, they are simply one of the best. They are the best team in the league. Let's just put it what it is. They have 100 points. They are sitting, what would be the President's Trophy right now, which is the most points in the league come the end of the season. They have it all. They have great defense. They have great offense. They have enough depth. They can play big. They can play fast. And they had a few players, Torrey Krug and Brandon Carlo, who were day-to-day before this season was paused. But now they're going to come back even healthier. The older guys are going to be rested. There's no reason not to like them this season.
Despite the Bruins' age, they also have that experience, obviously, having been there before. They're in a good spot, of course, performing. That's why they're your favorite. Plus 600 is what you can get them right now over at the FanDuel Sportsbook. So why things are paused, maybe make a little bet. Another favorite that you like at plus 700, it's the Tampa Bay Lightning, a team that's had a lot of regular season success but haven't really been able to get over the hump. Is this year going to be different?
Yeah, haven't been able to get over the hump, like you said. Hopefully this year is different for Tampa fans. Obviously, last year was a complete disaster for them. This is also a team that will benefit with the layoff. On March 3rd, they announced that Steven Stamkos, one of their best players, was going to be out 6 to 8 weeks with a core muscle surgery. So that would put him around the middle of May or so coming back, which would be sometime in the second round. But that's obviously not the case. So they're going to be getting back a superstar player. And really, overall, they have a super, super deep team. And at the trade deadline, they made a lot of, sneaky good moves, getting specifically Blake Coleman, which I think is a great pickup. And then you look deeper down their lineup. Like, they have this player, Anthony Cirelli, who's a center now, thrust up to onto the first forward line. But he's phenomenally defensively. He plays on the penalty kill. Not a lot of, a lot of people know about him. Everyone's going to be looking to Nikita Kucherov and Stamkos and Victor Hedman. And, of course, Vezina candidate Andrei Vasilevskiy and net. They have a ton of star players, but the depth is what really sets them apart from other teams. So plus 700 for a team that can really put up any amount of goals you possibly want. They can get it done.
They can get it done. Like you said, last year was a disaster for them. We're hoping this year they can turn it around. You named all the pieces that are in place. Hopefully they put it together in a timely manner and the right time whenever those NHL playoffs do begin. Up next for us, our last favorite, if you will, at plus 850, it's the Colorado Avalanche that have rebuilt and rebuilt well, putting them in position this year to be a true Stanley Cup contender. Why do you like the Avalanche?
So as I mentioned at the top of the Bruins, this is probably the team in the entire league that's going to benefit most from whatever amount of time this layoff happens to be. They have their star center, Nathan MacKinnon, who's only going to be sidelined for 1 to 2 weeks. But they are still without Mikko Rantanen, Nazem Kadri, Andre Burakovsky. Those are four forwards among their top six, along with their starting goaltender out, Philip Grubauer. So they have four of their best six forwards, four of their best six offensive options that were out or are out right now. They come back healthier. They do have a capable backup in Pavel Francouz net, who's been playing actually very well. But, sitting with one game in hand, I don't know what they're going to be doing with the games when it comes to resuming the season, but one game in hand, and they are 2 points out of the first place in the Western Conference. So they are moving along despite these injuries. And when they come back, they will be even healthier. There's no reason not to like a team that has all of the offense you can possibly want. When it comes to the goaltending, that's where things get a little bit dicey. But man, load up on these guys that are coming back healthy and will be in a great spot to win.
Absolutely. This long layoff's really going to help the Colorado Avalanche and put them in a position to be successful in the Stanley Cup playoffs. You got to like them at this value here. So jump on it now before everybody kind of sees how healthy this team is going to get. The Avalanche, a nice bet at this value. Speaking of value, let's go to some of these value plays that our long shots put, well, they can do it. As we know, anything can happen in the NHL playoffs. We begin with the Philadelphia Flyers at plus 1,300 here on the season. Why do you think the Flyers can make some noise?
So 1,300, I think, is a really great price for the Flyers right now. And, looking at this team overall, they kind of remind me of last year's St. Louis Blues team, where You know, they have that one star player. The Blues had Tarasenko. The Flyers have Claude Giroux. And then it's kind of a bunch of players that are just good, and they all play their role really well. And you look at this team and saying, you don't want to go against them in a seven-game series. They can play physical. They have a good young goalie in Carter Hart. They have enough defense. They have good coaching, Alain Vigneault, who took the Rangers to the Stanley Cup Final. He has the coaching experience in the playoffs, but this team hasn't been able to get over the hump when it comes to the playoffs. They have Voracek. They have Sean Couturier. All these guys that have been to the first round and out, combined with how well they've been playing, combined with the depth, with the new coach, with Alain Vigneault, first year with the Flyers, I think that they're bringing all the pieces together. And listen, this is a team, if we want to go back to the old Broad Street Flyers, that can play really physical, and you do not want to go against them every other night for a seven-game series time and time again. So Flyers at plus 1,300, you got to like them this year.
Like you said, a physically demanding team that's going to beat you up over a seven-game series, much like the Blues from a year ago. We have seen the Blackhawks also have a lot of success with this type of play. The Bruins, too, a good spot for the Philadelphia Flyers. Good value here at plus 1,300 as well. I don't want to face the bruising Flyers this year. Up next for us, and also at plus 1,300, it's the Pittsburgh Penguins, who always do seem to get hot at the right time. And you're like, all right, at plus 1,300, I feel like I need to sprinkle on the Penguins, right?
I mean, yeah, so much experience when it comes to the playoffs. Crosby and Malkin seemingly doing it every single year. But this is really a team that has dealt with it all this year. Crosby was hurt. Malkin was hurt. Hornquist was hurt. Chris Letang was hurt. Some of their depth players. Nick Bjugstad was hurt. But most importantly, depending on how long this layoff lasts, the interesting note is when it comes to Jake Guentzel, who was having a phenomenal year for the Penguins, 43 points in 39 games. He got hurt on December 30th of last year. They said his shoulder injury would be out 4 to 6 months. We are approaching April, and depending on how long this layoff lasts, Jake Guentzel, a legitimate top six forward, top line, top power play, whatever you want to call it, could be coming back in slot. Now, this is purely speculation, but a team that has the experience combined with the speed and skill that Guentzel brings, you want some action on this team. You don't want to be fading Crosby and Malkin, who are getting healthier, who are older in age, both well over 30, who can use this time off. So plus 1,300, we have two teams from the Keystone State here. I like Philly, and I like the Pittsburgh Penguins.
In the Eastern Conference, the Philadelphia Flyers, the Pittsburgh Penguins both have some experience. And the Penguins, with those stars like Sidney Crosby, always put them in a position to be successful. We'll see if this year they get the magic back. This layoff may help them as well. One final value team to get to, Tom, which brings us to the Edmonton Oilers. That plus 2,000, Connor McDavid, can he get healthy and win a cup?
Yeah, the Oilers are a team I think myself and a lot of people want to see make a run. Leon Draisaitl leading the league with 110 points. McDavid right behind him at 97, two of the most electric players in the league. They have a good amount of depth. It comes to Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, Darnell Nurse, Kyler Yamamoto. They picked up Tyler Ennis. But after that, that's where things get questionable. That's why we see them sitting at plus 2,000. Their goaltending with Koskinen and Mike Smith is really just a coin flip. They're both average goaltenders. Like, you would look at this list and you'd say, okay, Tuukka Rask from the Bruins, he could win you a game by himself in the playoffs. Vasilevskiy with the Lightning, he can win you a game by himself. When it comes to the Oilers, they really don't have that, and they're kind of relying on McDavid and Draisaitl to get them there, but their division is weak, and they can certainly get a favorable seat, combined with the fact that McDavid gets a little bit healthier after missing some time. And at plus 2,000, you really are just banking on the two best players in the league to carry this team throughout the playoffs.
As you said, both goaltenders kind of average for Edmonton. But the good news about the NHL playoffs is you just need a goaltender to get hot, get a little streaky. And you name a bunch of other players that could have some success with Edmonton. And again, it's all about streakiness in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Anything could happen. The Oilers at plus 2,000 is certainly on the table. That's going to do it for us here on the FanDuel Hurry Up Time. We appreciate the time, and stay safe, man.
Same to you.
We'll be back next time for more of the FanDuel Hurry Up. For Tom Vecchio, I'm Gregg Sussman. Stay safe, everybody.